Living Seed Media brings to you God's Word, which is His comprehensive equipment for changing lives. May the Lord impact your heart as you encounter His Word. For further inquiry or counsel, contact Peace House, P.O. Box 971, Boko, Benue State, Nigeria. Telephone numbers 0703-036-3659, 0703-768-1198. Email address lsmedia@livingseed.org or visit our website at www.livingseed.org. Let us sit back and listen as the servant of God brings forth the word of life.
Our Father, we thank you and bless you this morning. Thank you for this great opportunity to sit at your feet for instructions. This morning we ask that as even you instruct us, your people shall be willing. Lord, we are asking that none of us will misbehave to waste this day of your power. We are asking that you will make us ready in the name of Jesus Christ. We realize that this day of your power has two legs. There is the divine leg, there's also the human leg. There is what you will do, and there is what we shall do on our own part. We beg you, Lord, we beg you, that even on our own part, we will not miss it in the name of Jesus Christ. This morning, we ask that you will prevail on our lives. Prevail on our lives. Compel us to comply in the name of Jesus Christ. Let there be understanding, let there be the right utterance in the name of Jesus Christ. Cause that this trumpet will sound well, so we can prepare for battle. Thank you for hearing us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Luke chapter 5, from verse 1. And it came to pass that as the people pressed upon him to hear the word of God, he stood by the lake of Gennesaret, and saw two ships standing by the lake. But the fishermen were gone out of them, and were washing their nets. And he entered into one of the ships, which was Simon's, and prayed him that he would thrust out a little from the land. And he sat down and taught the people out of the ship. Now, when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep and let down your net for a draught. And Simon answering said unto him, Master, we have toiled all the night and have taken nothing. Nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down the net. And when they had this done, they enclosed a great multitude of fishes, and their net brake. And they beckoned unto their partners, which were in the other ship, that they should come and help them. And they came and filled both the ships, so that they began to sink. When Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, "Depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O Lord." For he was astonished, and all that were with him at the draught of the fishes which they had taken. And so was also James and John, the sons of Zebedee, which were partners with Simon. And Jesus said unto Simon, "Fear not, from henceforth thou shalt catch men." And when they had brought their ships to land, they forsook all and followed him. Psalm 110, verse 3. "Thy people shall be willing in the day of your power, in the beauties of holiness, from the womb of the morning. Thou hast the dew of thy youth." Like I've said, the day of his power has two legs. There is a divine leg, which is what the Lord himself must do. There's no delegation about it. But also, there is the human leg, which is our own part as a people to play. And we are looking at a situation here. We saw Peter and his two brothers as professional fishermen. And I hope that you know that Jesus' lineage is from woodworking, was from the family of carpenters. How can a carpenter teach a fisherman how to catch fish? Is it correct? Peter was not going to make a chair. He was not going to make a bed. He was going to catch fish. And from the Bible record, he had done all that profession demanded. All through the night, he was bringing his expertise to make a great catch. But by the time the day was breaking, he scored zero. A whole professional failed. The man who knew how to catch fish in the day and in the night, he failed. The man who grew up and was trained as a fisherman, he got nothing. The meaning of nothing means nothing, actually. Not even the tiny, tiny, tiny fish, there was nothing. And in disappointment, by the morning, he was now washing his net to go. When we talk about a fisherman washing net, it's not the use of soap like you wash clothes. You have thrown your net inside the river. Instead of catching fish, you pick some rubbish, dead leaves, pieces of sticks, and all of that. And when you are washing, you have come to the seashore and you are removing those dead things. Those things that are not wanted, you are removing them, and the next thing usually is to go home. So the professional had actually given up. Said, "There's nothing here." Are you a preacher of the gospel who is already washing your net because over the years there's no result? All that you gather inside your church is like Nothing, because there's no standing result. You don't have members that you can even trust. And you have now decided that instead of wasting my time, let me go to business or do something else. And some have already given their church halls for cinema. People have rented church halls to be showing films. They say that is better than catching nothing. At that point of disappointment, the day of the Lord appeared to Simon. Jesus just appeared there. But they were far apart in their trainings. When he came, the first thing he did was he requested Peter's sheep. Say, give me your sheep. Peter was looking for fish. Jesus is saying, give me your sheep. Peter is already tired, is preparing to go home, and Jesus was coming to delay him much more. Give me your sheep. I want to stand in your sheep and to preach. And I don't know how long or short that sermon was. But this man has already labored in the night and was tired and was getting ready to go home. We trust that in the course of this meeting, the day of the Lord will come to you in the name of Jesus Christ. We trust that where you have labored and didn't get any results, your nets will begin to break with results in the name of Jesus Christ. As we were doing the Bible study yesterday, we saw that under the revival in Moses and Deborah, it was always at the point of disappointment that their own day came. When Jesus made that request, Peter found it very difficult to comply. But he agreed. Verse 4 said he actually released his sheep to the Lord, and the Lord preached and finished preaching, and then began to give him instructions that had to do with the day of his power. What was it? Launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a drought. Now it is clear to me that even in the day of the Lord, when you are fishing on the shore, you will catch nothing. You will need to launch into the deep. We are going to be asking God as we pray, Lord, deliver me from superficial Christianity. Take me into the deep. Deliver me from lazing about. Launch me into the hard work. That's where you will see the result. It is Peter's answer that I want us to hear him very well. In verse 4, Jesus gave instruction that had to do with the day of his power. But in verse 5, Peter is also going from the professional point. He said, Master, we have toiled all the night and have taken nothing. Who are the we in that scripture? He said, Master, we. Who are the we? He said, we professionals. We who have all that it takes to catch fish. We trained people born in the profession, grew in the profession. We and we have caught nothing. If that statement were to be complete, he would have said, so what can a carpenter be teaching us? But I saw that in the day of his power, help will come for us. So instead of speaking wrongly, the first good thing is that he recognized that Jesus is the master. He said, Master! Master! And to me, master means the master of all fields. The first help that came to Peter was that, look, I am speaking with the master of the universe. I'm not just speaking with a Jesus of Nazareth. I'm speaking with the master of the universe. The man that is capable of handling every situation. The man that is able to deal with failures. The man that is able to give us results where we didn't find before. He said, Master, and may the Lord be your master this day in the name of Jesus Christ. If he's anything less than master, even this day will be a waste for you. If you have a vehicle that is broken down and people showed you a good mechanic, they said, this is the master mechanic in this town, and you carry your vehicle to the place, the next thing is to relax. Trust will make you believe that I have come to the right place and we go out with great result. My vehicle will come back to shape. Yesterday morning we were looking at a very important aspect. Faith. When the Lord spoke, faith arose from the heart of Peter. By the help of God, he was able to put his profession aside and so the master. He said, Master! But let me tell you a story. We have toiled all through the night and have taken nothing. If he stopped there, he was going to waste the day of the lost power. But look at the statement he added. He said, Nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down the net. In the day of the lost power, only willingness and obedience will give us results. Nevertheless means, even though by my training, there's nothing here. No fish. I grew up in this profession. I have fish in the day. I have fish in the night. From all experience, there will be no catch here. But since it is you, the master, who is speaking and giving me instruction, he said, Nevertheless, I will obey. May the Lord dismantle all your professionalism in the name of Jesus Christ. May the Lord dismantle every argument in your heart in the name of Jesus Christ. May the Lord dismantle anything that stands against the working of the day of his power in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. It's possible for the day to appear, but it's also possible for us to waste it. Peter, by the help of God, was not going to waste this. Nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down thy net. And when they had this done, they enclosed great multitude of fishes, and their net break. In the day of the Lord, where you have worked before and you caught nothing, and you have decided to wash your net and to go home and to retire from the work of God and to drop anything godly, in the day of the Lord, there will be results. Not small results. They caught fish so much that the Bible said their net began to break. Where were the fishes before? Or rather, where did the fish come from? Because just a few minutes ago, the man labored there and didn't find anything. Now the fishes are so much that the net is breaking. Where did the fish come from? The fish came from the spoken word of the master. We will not get the result of this day by any other means. We will get it by listening to the instruction from the master and obeying them. Somebody may look like me. You have attempted praying for sick people many times and there was no result. So you have washed your nets. Each time you see a sick man that is needing prayer, something told you that he can't walk with me. As far as you are concerned, you are only there to refer to other people. In the day of your power, when you meet such cases where you found disappointment before, listen to the Lord. If he says, go ahead, go ahead, and the result will tear your net. The professional himself was shocked at the result. He was thinking, where were these fishes a few minutes ago that I went everywhere up and down and I didn't find? Where did they come from? Because you see, as he was laboring, when the day hadn't come, if he got a result, I would have been surprised. When the day of the Lord now came, by all means, result must come from where there was none. So he caught and the net was breaking. May you have nevertheless in your life. A situation that you allow God to overrule. Peter is saying, ordinarily, I will never put my net in this water again. But because you are the master and you have spoken, let me obey. And it was as he did that, that he saw result. Verse 7 said, because of the much catch, they beckoned unto their partners, which were in the other ship, that they should come and help them. The powers of denomination will be broken in the day of the Lord. All those people that hitherto we had nothing to do with, partners from the other ship, result, overwhelming result, will make us to be friends. We will call them because the result will be too much for you to handle as a single denomination. So they beckon on them and say, come and help us. We cannot handle result. And good enough, those other people didn't say, which denomination are you? In the day of his power, help us, we walk together. In the day of his power, useless questions like, what is your denomination? What is your rank? Mm-mm. Even those who have been standing idle, the day of his power will engage them. You know that those two other ships, there was nothing, no catch, no anything. But the result of this Peter's ship also engaged them. They called unto them, and they came. They filled both ships so that they began to sink. Verse 8. When Peter saw it, what did he see? The miracles in the day of his power. When Peter discovered that professionalism is not greater than the day of his power. When Peter discovered that this man he called and addressed as master actually proved himself the master. When Peter saw that what he couldn't get, he got it very simply within a short time by the instruction of the master. He said, "Depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O Lord." When the day has not come, everybody will think he's a Christian. Huh? When the day has not come, everybody will think he's a Christian. When the day has not come, even backsliders will be prominent in the church. When the day has not come, sinners will be on the pulpit. But when the day of the Lord came, Peter said, "I am a sinner, depart from me." It's going to be very sweet to serve the Lord when his day comes. You won't be struggling with sinners. When the day of his power has not come, people will only seek prominence. Somebody will buy one ceiling fan and say, "Donated by the king, this, or something, this. When the day of his power comes, nobody will look at the fan. You will look at yourself. You will even wonder what gave you the right to even bring a gift to the house of God. You, a sinner. It will become clear to you that God is not looking for what you can provide. He's looking for your heart. He's saying, "My son, give me your heart." Isaiah was a prominent preacher before. But in chapter 6, when the day of the Lord's power came, Isaiah also said, "I'm a sinner, I'm a man with unclean lips, and I dwell among sinners. Have mercy on me." If you look at that scripture very well, did Jesus preach any sermon? The only thing was launch into the deep. Very simple instruction. It is the result that brought conversion. But yesterday we were also told to be wise. Instead of asking the Lord to pack, say, "Depart." No. We will say, "Thank you, Lord. Stay with us." Peter said, "I'm a sinner. Depart from me." But we will say we are sinners, but stay with us. Help us. It is as you stay with us, there will be cleansing, there will be purification, there will be sanctification. Stay with us. Why did he come to that? The result of the day of his power surprised him. We were told that the day of our battle is over. The appearance of this day will bring deliverance to us. It will bring healing to us. It will bring grace to us. It will bring power to us in the name of Jesus Christ. And as he did it, they said James and John also followed. Which means that same result affected all of them. Jesus said unto Simon, fear not. From henceforth, thou shalt catch men. Oh. Jesus said to Peter, if the result of catching fish surprises you, what will happen when you begin to catch men and your net are breaking? You know, sometimes you stumble over a miracle by accident. I describe it that way because occasionally it happens, sometimes it doesn't happen. That somebody will come with an illness, you pray and then it's okay. But some other times you do that same thing and there's nothing. Jesus was telling Peter, this thing that you have seen is small. I will move you from the realm of catching fish onto the realm of catching men. Each and every one of us is going to be moved higher in the name of Jesus Christ. You won't only be catching fish. You will catch men. Actually, the essence of the day of his power is not just for ordinary fish. It's to catch men. And when they had brought their ships to land, they forsook all and followed him. Verse 11 is where we are going to stop and to pray. When they had brought all to land, they left the resort there and followed him. It is not the result that will become our pursuit in the day of his power. It will be him. If he's not there, there will be no result. Now, so when they made that large catch, result didn't take them away from the Lord. It was a small thing for them to forsake. Said they forsook all. All means both the fish and the sheep and even their professionalism. They forsook all and to follow. In the day of his power, only Christ is central. What is going to be our prayer today? Peter said, nevertheless, we are going to be asking God, deliver me from what I think I know. Deliver me from my expertise. Because that is going to work against the day of his power. If God didn't help him and he insisted that, look, I'm a professional, I have tried this place, I didn't make any cut, you know, he will lose even the Lord Jesus Christ. But he said, Master, at your word I will obey. Lord, this morning we stand before you asking that you will deliver us from ourselves in the name of Jesus Christ. Deliver me, O God, from self-confidence. Peter felt that, look, if I have tried to catch fish and I didn't catch, who else will teach me how to catch? But God helped him to recognize the Lord as the master. And when he submitted, even with all his years of fishing, he saw a result that surprised him. This morning is another day. Actually, today is the third day. On the third day, there are usually miracles. On the third day, the stone on the tomb will move. On the third day, there will be earthquake. On the third day, the Lord of Lords will rise up from the grave. On the third day, there will be transformation. On the third day, even the security men at the tomb, they fell down and the Lord arose. This day is very precious. I want you to sit with very high expectation that the Lord will do unto us beyond what we know. And when the result of these days is coming, let us also pray that God will help us not to cling to the result and allow the master of the result to go. Say, even when everything had came to the land, they forsook all and followed him. Shall we pray together? I'd like you to thank God for granting you help to become a witness to the day of his power. Thank God that he has met you at the point where you are washing your nets. Things have made you tired. You are almost giving up. You are discouraged. Nothing is working. You put hand here, no result. Put hand here, no result. And the Lord has seen your predicament. He has appeared. I want you to thank him. You have been having broken courtship for long. This one will start, it will break. It will start, it will break. You have opened many churches, they never last. Members will just come and then disappear. Churches are dying. You are at the point of washing your net, but the Lord has appeared. Struggling with sin habits. You do all the fasting, you do everything. And as you're finishing, your problem comes back again. Struggling with sickness, struggling with difficult marriages. Some of us, even in our marriages, we have washed our nets. But as a man, this marriage is a mistake. It will not work. It will not work. The day of the Lord's power has appeared. It shall work. Student, you are struggling with results that tempted you to start doing exam malpractice. The day of the Lord has appeared. You will get results where there was no results in the name of Jesus Christ. Are you in business? You actually wanted to do it in the way of the Lord, but every time you launch into it, it will not work. The day of the Lord. Very majorly, I want you to ask God, Lord, this is my Christian life that is superficial. Help me, Launch me into the deep in the name of Jesus Christ. You read your Bible, no understanding, you want to pray, it's not working. You're already washing your net, you have decided, I will just leave it. How did the Bible become like a newspaper unto you? You kneel down to pray, in 2 minutes you're already gone, sleep. Peter said, Master, I have tried. But my trial didn't work. Tell the Lord to launch you into the deep, to push you into the deep, to deepen your relationship with Him. Raka Santa Katrobokos Kontorobakashta Baba Sandara Baba Sai Raka Santa Bas Kalibas Kontorobakata Baka Seteri Baba. In the name of Jesus. And when they brought all to the land, the fish, the sheep, themselves, their professionalism, said they forsook all and followed Him. Lord, move us forward. Lord, move us forward. Cause us to follow. Cause us to follow. Cause me to follow. Can you pray for yourself that this day you will still move with the Lord? The result that you have already gotten, leave it behind. Move with the Lord. Move with the Lord. Lord, move me on. Move me forward. Move me forward. Cause me to follow. Cause me to follow. Cause me to follow. Let no result delay me. Lord, let no result delay me. Let me not cling to any result. And they followed Him. And they followed Him. Reba Santa Rabababa Rabba Santa Baskali Askanta Rabakata Raka Santa Paskaliba Orababa Santa Baskali Baskondobakata Oribaba Santa Rababashla Baskalia Reke Santa Katubakata Bakaskalia Reke Santa Katubakata Bakaska Bakata Orabaka Santa Maskalia Oraba Grace to follow Him. Orabaka Santa Maskab. In the day of His power, Jesus is central. Results must not delay me. And they followed Him. Pray that you will move with Him. Rika Santa Pascalibos Contarabacata, Rabasanda Rababashla Bascalia, Oria Rabasanda Basca, Paurabasanda Rababashla Bascalia, Rekasete Catubacata, Orabaca Santa Bascalia, Rebosonda Mamascanta Bascalia, Pauracasa Carabacata, Urabaca Santa Rababa, Oria Rabasanda Bascalia, Raca Santa Catubacata, Urabaca Santa Bascaba, Urababa Santa Bascalia.